In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious, our dearest viewers, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Al-Imam Hussein TV 3, where today we are remembering one of the great personalities who supported Al-Imam Hussein's revolution of justice and liberty. He is Muslim ibn Aqil, the martyr and the ambassador of Al-Imam Hussein to Al-Kufa. Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, in 15th of Ramadan, 60 after Hijrah, was dispatched by Al-Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, to Al-Kufa to respond to thousands of letters which had been sent by the people of Al-Kufa requesting and demanding from Al-Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, to come to them to rescue them from the tyranny of the Bani Umayyah. So Al-Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, dispatched his ambassador Muslim ibn Aqil to them to verify their intentions and to make sure they are ready to join Al-Imam's mission of liberation and emancipation from the oppression of the Umayyads. Al-Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, said to Muslim ibn Aqil, once you get there, stay with the most trustworthy of its people. And as soon as Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, entered the Kufa, he stayed at the house of Al-Mukhtar al-Thaqafi, a companion of the Ahlul Bayt who was highly respected among his people. And he was a generous man, a man of ambition and daring, and he was a formidable opponent of the enemies of the Ahlul Bayt. He kept company with the progeny of the Prophet Muhammad, and he benefited from their ethics, morals, and he sought their advices publicly and privately. The people of Al-Kufa met Muslim ibn Aqil at the house of Al-Mukhtar al-Thaqafi, and according to has narrated that the number of those who swore the oath of allegiance to Muslim ibn Aqil exceeded 18,001. So, as a matter of fact, Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, wrote back to Mecca informing Al-Imam Hussein of their intentions, and he stated, "Hurry and come to us, O son of the Messenger of Allah. 100,000 swords are in Kufa on your side, so do not tarry." And for sure, that act angered the supporters or foes of Al-Imam Hussein, peace be upon him. So they wrote to Yazid, son of Muawiyah, informing him of the arrival of Muslim ibn Aqil and the rallying of people behind him. Adding to that, An-Nu'man ibn al-Bashir, the governor of Al-Kufa at that time, was not strong enough to stand in Muslim's way. So Yazid, son of Muawiyah, ordered to dispose An-Nu'man ibn al-Bashir, and he appointed Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad in his place. And the new governor was a man very well known for his ruthlessness and brutality. And of course, Yazid, son of Muawiyah, ordered Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, who was in Basra, to rush to Al-Kufa to stop Muslim ibn Aqil from marching against their oppressive authority. And as soon as he entered the Kufa, Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad gathered the people of Al-Kufa, and he said that anyone found to be sheltering one of those who skim against the authority of the commander of faithful and does not hand him over, he will be crucified at the door of his own house. When Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, came to know about Ibn Ziyad's explicit threats, and having come to know about people's conditions, so he feared being assassinated. Therefore, he left the house of Al-Mukhtar al-Thaqafi and he went to the house of Hani ibn Urwa, a companion of the Ahlul Bayt. He was one of Al-Kufa's dignitaries and he was one of the closest friends and companion of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. So the people of Al-Kufa met Muslim ibn Aqil at the house of Hani ibn Urwa secretly without attracting any attention of Ibn Ziyad. Therefore, Ibn Ziyad couldn't know where Muslim was. But the secret spies of Ibn Ziyad kept infiltrating till they found where Muslim was. And when the matter became clear to Ibn Ziyad, who by now we knew that Muslim ibn Aqil was at the house of Hani ibn Urwa, so he summoned Hani ibn Urwa and he started to interrogate him and question him and dealing with him rudely and threatening to kill him. And of course, when Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, saw the intimidation of Ibn Ziyad and the arrest of Hani ibn Urwa, so he ordered one of his companions to call upon his men, those who swore the oath of allegiance, to support him. And of course, he had 4,000 men assembled. But the substance from which the people of Al-Kufa were made was a treasury. Their standards kept disappearing till no more than 300 out of the original 4,000 remained with him. And when Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, offered the evening prayer at the Grand Mosque of Al-Kufa, he saw less than 30 men remained with him. And when he had highly proceeded for a short while before finding himself with no one, so he alighted from his horse and he cautiously traversed Al-Kufa's allies without knowing where to go. And of course, Ibn Ziyad ordered his forces to search homes and highways. And of course, he ordered to torture those who stood up with Muslim ibn Aqil. And Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, was a stranger who had no family, no tribe. And his feet took him to one of Al-Kufa's quarters, where he saw a Fred woman standing at the threshold of her home. So, and she was called Tawa. So he requested from her to quench his thirst and to, of course, to host him. And one of Tawa's sons was named Bilal. And Bilal was one of the supporters of Ibn Ziyad. And when Bilal saw that Muslim ibn Aqil in his mother's house, so he rushed to Ibn Ziyad and he informed him of where Muslim had been hiding. Ibn Ziyad ordered his forces to go to the house of Tawa and to arrest Muslim ibn Aqil. Fighting intensified. Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, exchanged fighting with his foes. And of course, one of the soldiers struck Muslim ibn Aqil and he cut the upper lip, wounding the lower one. And they attacked Muslim ibn Aqil from all directions, hurling rocks at him. And of course, Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, was arrested and was taken to the top of the Ibn Ziyad palace, where his head was beheaded, and both of his head and his body were thrown from the top of the palace to the ground. Thus, Muslim ibn Aqil, peace be upon him, was a martyr who supported Imam Hussein, peace be upon him, mission of dignity and justice and liberty. So peace be upon you, O my master, O ambassador of Imam Hussein, O Muslim ibn Aqil. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.